Hi, this is Amitash. You're watching After Hours with Karun Raman on Cinemaplusnews.
After Hours with Karun Raman is always fun. It's hep, it's cool, very slazzy, very sleazy. No, very slazzy always. And my show is filled with a lot of interesting people. We have pub reviews, we have cinema stars. We have a lot of interesting people on board, which actually bring in that oomph factor. And we have a very close friend of mine, AmitashPradhan over here. Hi, Amitash.
What's up?
What's up?
How's it going?
So, Amitash and I, it's not like a proper interview that I do with the other film stars. This is much more like him and I chilling at a bar or at a restaurant or at a family function. So, how is so much of humdrum about Vaanam Kottattum?
Yeah.
And you've been playing a character called Kalyan in the film.
Yeah.
And obviously you have a huge fan following, comes to women and young girls who are crazy about you. And this is a very different character that you've played in the movie.
Yeah.
People aware under the influence, thinking that you had more screen presence with Aishwarya than the other co-star in the film.
Mm-hmm.
How was it to act with Aishwarya and your experience with Mr. Dhana and Madras Talkies?
First of all, very happy and glad to be on the show.
Thank you.
I feel pretty cool now.
It's cool.
Now that I'm on this show.
After all the planning we
did. Yeah. So, that brings me to a very important point of how everything happens at the right time. And I've known Mani sir and everyone for about 10 to 12 years now. And Mani sir has obviously been a very, very influential force growing up, because my definition of cinema has revolved around Mani Ratnam and Rajinikanth. So, that was pretty surreal, because, and it's not that, it's not, like, you know people often believe that people do land these paths on influence or anything of that sort, but if that had to happen, then I would have been cast in like 10 years ago from the time I've known them, because my parents have known them for a very long time. But everything has the right time.
Definitely.
And I think it's the right time for me to be part of a film like this also, because mentally I'm ready now. I'm like, I feel like I'm in a better space. So, I think mentally I was ready to take this opportunity with like both hands, because obviously nobody's going to say no to this.
Obviously not.
It's Mani sir. Yeah. And I had the opportunity to work with such talented people, because it's an ensemble cast. It's an 8-member cast. So, I got some private time with Sharad sir, which was very cool, because I think he's like the Jackie Shroff of the South.
He's Aishwarya's dad in the movie.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, yeah, I spent some time with him, and Aishu's just a remarkable person to work with. She's so easy, she's so in the flow of things, that when you act with her, you don't really have to put, there's no putting in effort at that point, it just flows. And I think that's when you can really create something special on screen, because you're not actually trying to create it, you're just being it.
Correct.
So that's why one feeling that I felt with Aishwarya. There was a sneak peek that came out with me having a Thirittadam.
Yeah, I was just watching it actually.
Yeah, so that scene was very organic, because both of us, I think we both come from the same school of thought with how we approach our performances, because we believe in like similar ideologies. So getting together with her in the film was pretty cool, and Shantanu as well, actually.
Yeah.
Shantanu has been a good friend for a while, and both of us have been trying to work our way up, and I really think that this is a good year for him, because he's doing a film with Vijay sir. So I think we're all growing at the same time. I feel happy to see.
So it's no more that the star kids get all the attention. There is scope for actors who start from scratch.
I think that's the case everywhere in India right now. Because if you see the rise of people like Vicky Kaushal, and I know Vicky Kaushal's industry, but he didn't have a acting parent or producer parent. He was a stunt master.
Yeah.
Shyam Kaushal, Vicky's father, Rajkumar Rao, Ayushman.
Yeah.
All of these people are doing such good work right now, despite not being, like family kids or industry kids.
Correct.
And I think that if you're good today, you're recognized. That's about it.
That's about it.
I feel like there's so many streams and platforms to be recognized right now that you have to understand which works for you the best and try to tap into that space. And if you're good, you're going to be recognized for sure. Because as much as I hear this word nepotism, I think the three biggest stars of India have been self-made people.
Definitely.
which is Mr. Rajinikanth, Mr. Shah Rukh Khan, and probably Mr. Amitabh Bachchan.
Yeah.
So I think they're all self-made people, they're not from the industry.
Correct.
So, yeah.
That's true. How has your journey been since VIP 1,
yeah,
till now? you said that you've got a space that has not been there before.
Yeah.
You said you've matured in the industry.
Yeah.
You've seen a different side of Amitash right now.
Mm.
Is this side going to improvise more, or is Amitash comfortable with this?
No, no. I hope. I hope to keep taking it up, because you know, I really believe. When I see a film, I have this particular thought of how I try to take everything from the film. I try to, like, you know, see how much I can take back from a character, from a scene, from a moment that was created on screen. I try to look at it as I'm taking everything. That's why I go to a film, you know. I enjoy a film, but I also love to take back the takebacks that come with it, being in the industry and knowing how it works in a certain level. So I'm, of course, I think it'd be great to sound aspirational, but the truth of the matter is that, of course, I'd like to keep growing, because that I've enjoyed throughout my school. People kept saying it's not the joy of just winning. It's not just winning. Participating also makes a lot of difference. For me, that's very at that point it seemed very, you know, frivolous, because I'm like, what are you talking about? You have to win, otherwise correct. You're not respected,
correct,
right?
Yeah.
So that was the vibe then. But as I grew up and as I got out of and got into the real world, so as to speak, I began to believe.
Definitely, yeah. And I think your mom and dad have been a very major influence in your life.
Yeah.
I think that's a very known fact that some of us have been noticing, especially, you know, to have parents like that to support you and push you is a blessing, because not many kids have the kind of nerve to proceed in their careers,
yeah,
especially.
Absolutely.
So, Amitash, tell me something. So, you have a lot of fan following. Which is like the most craziest moment that you've ever had with a fan? It can be an Instagram, it can be a personal phone call, it could be somebody hugging you, biting you.
The first weird experience I had was when I went out after VIP for a function. And this girl openly propositioned me, and I was like, what?
She asked me to marry her.
Yeah, I was like, hey, let's chat, guys, because I really like interactions. I don't like to just, like, talk. I believe information exchange is really important. So I like interacting with people. So when I asked them, and I gave them the mic, and I said, hey, what's up, how are you doing? One girl just said straight up, will you marry me? And that was the first time I experienced something like that. I was like, wait, what just happened? But there's another person, a very sweet person who I know means the best for me. She did send me a message asking me if her parents can go ahead with their process of marriage with respect to her, or should she wait for me? And I was like,
What is After Hours for Amitash?
I'm a pretty late sleeper, to be honest. I don't sleep early because I like to. I think this time between 4 p.m. and 3 a.m. is like my most productive, prolific time.
Okay.
I think that's the most the time I function the best in. So I like watching. I like, you know, chilling with my friends at home.
I have a huge circle of friends, from what I know.
Yes, and every night there's this congregation of people that just comes together at my place, and it's quite wonderful, because everybody comes with, like, I really like facilitating conversation. So this is a really nice question, for because I've never been asked it before. I love to cultivate conversations. I love to listen to what people have to say. So outside my house there's this small setup, and it's known to just, that place has become synonymous with some good conversations, because we've had a lot of good conversations. Yeah. And obviously Netflix is a major force in everybody's life.
Definitely.
And I really just love sitting on my bed doing nothing and listening to music on my Marshall. I think that's
like your after hours.
That would be the last hour of the day for me, probably.
So how would you categorize when it comes to your go-to place, when it comes to somewhere you need to chill out, or somewhere you need to have a peaceful time for you to think? It's like it can be about your film, it can be about your personal life, it can be about your public appearances.
Yeah.
Where does Amitash chill? Don't say your bed at home.
In my head.
In your head.
I think that's a good answer. No?
Yeah.
It is. It really is.
It
because
is a good answer.
Because it's. I've come to discover for myself that I'm actually able to slowly begin to, like, switch spaces in my head with respect to on and off. So I think that off space is the chill space that everybody needs in a day to stay sane. Otherwise, like, I love work. I really, 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 I cannot stress enough how much I love my work. Like, I enjoy it from the bottom of my heart.
So 7th was the release of the film.
Yeah.
You went for the first day for show.
Yeah, I went to the end to just to,
okay,
to say thank you to all people who had
called. How was the response?
It was pretty good. People seemed very moved, and hence, I, you know, there are some films that end in a certain way where you come out laughing. Because I've read from Martin Scorsese that the last 15 minutes of the film are the most important part.
Definitely.
Parts of the film. So doing that goes two ways. One, you come out feeling really, you know, enriched, happy, and all of that. And on the other, you're moved. Like this other film I saw called 1917. Mm. I was really, really moved. But I, in fact, for the first time, I saw claps for the cinematographer and director of that film.
Oh, lovely.
And nobody knows, like, Roger Deakins is the DOP of the film and he's a legend, but people don't know too much of him.
Yeah.
But he's done some insane films. So coming back to Vaanam, I feel like people felt that moved because the climax is quite moving.
Yeah.
So I think it's emotional. So I think that people had that. It wasn't that film where they came out saying, oh my God, it's crazy. They needed a moment. And I'm really happy that happened because if films can make you think, if they can make you ponder, if they can make you reflect on your own life or the life around you, or you know, the fact that this kind of a life also exists, I think we've hit what we wanted to get at, I think. I hope.
I'm sure it is. I mean,
yeah.
Have you faced a lot of competition? Because industry has, you have a lot of friends who are actors, you have a lot of friends who are in the industry.
Yeah.
It might be a very feel-good factor for you to have a good hit or a good run when it comes to a film.
Yeah.
Have you had any backlashes with your friends indirectly? Have you had any issues that you faced?
Well, with my friends, no, because I think I was recently telling someone that I feel very happy that all the friends that I have in the industry are really good people. Right,
so, like, so you say that they're good for your benefit also.
Yeah, they're really good friends, and I it's nice that we have that equation. Like Ani, for example, he's my first friend in life. He literally was my first friend in life, 92 or 93 or something. So, I mean, have you heard anybody say anything about him?
Never.
It's always been only one. Yeah. There you go. Everybody's like that. Yeah. So I think it's
to have a little bit of that. Yeah. You know, jealousy.
No, not at all. Like if
not with your close friends, I'm talking with your acquaintances. No, meet, you go out. Nothing affects you.
I don't like to think of those things in my life. It just because if you get caught up in that game, then you're never going to be able to get out. It's like a maze that doesn't have an opening.
So I'm saying because all the other youngsters need to listen to this.
Yeah, because with this, what I think the biggest thrill of life should be to be able to shine and grow together.
Exactly, yeah.
Right? Because if we're all doing well, it's such a happy space for everyone. It becomes like an alpha state.
Yeah.
Right? So I think we should try to cultivate people growing and not look at it as competition at all. Because if you look at it as competition, you're going to feel sad.
Correct.
Why would you allow yourself to go through that having knowledge of that beforehand?
Correct. That's very true.
Yeah.
And you know, something which I've always wanted to tell a lot of people, because not many people know this, but Amitash is a fabulous singer also. I still remember how your mom was telling me when you were very young, you went and your granddad is not well, you went and sang this song.
What?
Song
she told
you were just laughing about
mom,
it.
Mom. You're on my list.
How much of a craze you've had.
So tell that story properly.
So your granddad was not well and everybody was searching for you and you were missing in that action.
Yeah.
And you were out somewhere singing, what is the song called?
I don't remember the song, it's a Shah Rukh song.
Some Shah Rukh Khan song.
Yeah.
And from that day is when they realized that your flair is not just this, it's you're made for cinema.
It's performance.
Performance.
I think performance drives me, whether it's, I did a dance film with a Hollywood dance film with the creator of Step Up.
Correct.
And that I enjoyed so much because 80% of the expression was through dance. It was a dance film. It was very step-up-ish rather.
For an Indian actor, yeah, it's a big thing.
Yeah, I mean, and it was a great process because at that point of time, I really got in touch with some lovely people because some wonderful people were attached to the project. So I got in touch with them, like Ravi Varman, the camera person, who's probably at the top in the country right now. I got to build a personal equation with him. Dwayne Adler, the guy who wrote the biggest billion-dollar dance franchise film in the world, I got to have an interaction with him. I got to know of him. He was my director.
Correct.
And it was the first time I was playing the lead as well in a film.
Yeah. Like, and the, for a Chennai boy to have that experience.
Yeah, it was great. So I think that performance, like recently for Vaanam, I've been singing a little bit for the promotions and all of that. And I've begun to enjoy that as well because I hadn't done that before on camera. Yeah. I'd done it like with my friends in a private group, like with where you've been as well.
Yeah, yeah.
But I don't think I've ever sung on a stage on a
like a performance.
Oh yeah, because my mom is very, very insistent that I do something with music.
Yeah.
Because she really believes that that's something that should be tapped from my side.
I believe.
Yeah.
I think I will
for sure.
So speaking, you're very versatile in that way. You're not just an actor. You have so much of talent in you that.
That's what I said. Performance.
Spread it.
Performance.
Yeah. So why don't you sing a line for me? No?
What song do you like?
Any song. What is your favorite song? Something for all your fans and for all of you.
There's a song that I think that goes well with the mood that you just said. Because I really want to say that in these 4 years that I've taken time to build myself to in the way that I have believed possible, people haven't forgotten, or people haven't forgotten to give me the love, because there was a Tamil film, then an English film which didn't release in India, and then there was Vaanam.
Yeah.
So up until that gap, people have been really supportive. They've still shown me the same love that they would have shown me if I had done 3 more films. So the song is for that, because the lyric, it's in Hindi, but the lyrics are actually pretty relevant to this.
हम तेरे बिन अब रह नहीं सकते, तेरे बिना क्या वजूद मेरा, क्योंकि तुम ही हो, अब तुम ही हो, जिंदगी अब तुम ही हो, चैन भी मेरा दर्द भी, मेरी आशिकी अब तुम ही हो.
Lovely. I think all the girls are going to be watching this. So Amitash, what is thing that you realize in Chennai has changed a lot when it comes to, is Chennai become more fashionable right now? There's so many actors are so drab, they don't take the trouble of dressing up. I've always noticed people, they think they're a star, so they need to be rugged and they need to be casual. But I think appearance is very important for a film star.
I mean, I think it's to each his own, but I do believe that the fashion scene is improving. Like
Ranveer Singh, like the airport scenes have improved.
See, but they come from, it comes from a different school of thinking also, the way perceived. I think that categorization is going to be difficult, but I think things are improving. Like people in the south who I can think of who dress really well are Dulkar.
Yes.
Vikram Prabhu and I go to the same guy.
Yeah,
Osman, who's a dear friend, you go to him as well. So Osman has really has upped the fashion game in Chennai. Definitely. For sure. Yeah. Because
Gabbana.life. Yeah,
Gabbana.life. Man, Osman, we love you, brother. So I think these things are happening, and I'm seeing people like, for example, I think there are some actors who are going to work in Bollywood as well.
See,
and
Bharat,
when I see them there, Bharat's always dressed well. Bharat's always dressed well. And Vijay Devarakonda, though, he's like a Ranveer Singh. He's that Ranveer Singh zone. Yeah. Like he goes in shorts.
Also, but he's very cool.
Yeah, he goes in shorts to interviews.
Yeah.
With like the most respected actors of India. Yeah. Chill. So that's a personality of its own.
Yeah.
So I think it's getting much better, and if we have like 10 to 15 style icons over the next 4 or 5 years as actors or actresses or sports people, anything basically representing us as a culture, it'll be pretty cool.
What is your style statement?
Mine is very confused. Yeah, I think my personal style is very confusing, but I love hoodies. I love long jackets, and I love hoodies.
How come we've never seen in a hoodie?
Because that's always in the gym or when I'm running. I love that look. I love that entire joggers, hoodie, and like, you know, nice sneakers.
Okay.
I like that look.
Okay.
I love dressing in suits.
I mean, who
doesn't? And Osman does them so well.
Yeah.
Sometimes I'm able to find some things that really work for me. So I love suits. And shorts is like a all-time favorite. I wish I could wear shorts everywhere I went.
But I don't think most of us get to see you in shorts. Or I think mostly because maybe you're at home. Or
no, I mean like nice shorts.
How the Vijay Devarakonda and like Ranveer Singh.
Yeah, possibly. Yeah, something
that's
like
a very
that.
New trend. Actually, not many people are following it though.
Yeah, but like I think I'll do it when I'm ready for it. Yeah. But I feel like shorts is something I love, chilling in shorts.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So where do we see Amitash in the next 4 years or 5 years?
I got no idea. I couldn't tell.
Release his own music album? Will he make his mom's dream come true? Will he be signing more international offers? What is going to happen?
So the thing I've realized about life is, if I'm going to anticipate these things, it almost never comes to working out.
Working towards it.
Yeah, yeah. But I'm saying, so in my head, I have certain goals of mine. I feel I need. I don't feel I need to reach a certain place. But I do feel I need to reach a certain place in my head to feel completely happy and successful for myself.
Okay.
I need to hit that space in my head first. So if I were to keep going on and keeping certain landmarks as what do you say, like very in a very hard way, then I'm going to probably, I'll feel disappointed every time I don't get there at a certain time. And I've begun to believe, I've become a big believer of the fact that things happen at the right time and they just come to you. Yeah. Like things that happen best for you are just organic.
Correct.
They just slide into you. Like you don't even have to try to look for them. They're there.
Correct.
So I think if I'm able to, like, I would love, I think my, the three films I've done this year, I feel have added a lot to my headspace, which in Vaanam I play a very energetic, happy-go-lucky kid. And in the Ninnukuri remake, which I'm doing with Atharva, I play an introvert. So people have already seen the original. I play an introvert. And the next film that I'm doing after that, I'm playing a college kid. And it's a really fun story.
It's all different. It's all such.
Yeah, it's different spaces. So I'm thinking it's adding to my, like, a good space in my head. And I'm happy that it is, because that's what I've been striving towards. I've been striving towards work. And now that I've found a nice rhythm in my head, for the first time, I'm able to build a rhythm for myself. Even in my the way I'm approaching my performance, I'm able to build a rhythm.
Okay.
That's something which I didn't do earlier.
So you're finding yourself in different spots right now. Like, Amitash is growing into a very young man, into his career.
Mm.
You're getting more sorted with what you want to write.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'd like to hope so.
Yeah, I think you are, because a lot of people have been talking about you off late. People have been saying good things. Have been saying this boy is focused. You've never let go of what you wanted to do.
Tunnel vision.
You're one of those very few boys who's always been motivated. You motivate people also. What would you like to tell the younger generation right now? There's so many boys who are depending on films, who waste their times walking behind directors, producers, getting misled. What advice would you want to give the younger generation right now when it comes to boys who want to get into films?
Well, that's an interesting question, because there is no concrete answer for this.
It's your experience.
I would say just keep the faith, because some days are going to be really hard. Some days you're going to feel like you're going to really undermine your own self. You're going to put your self-worth down. That these things are natural and they will happen. If me telling you to not let them happen is going to be fake. But because I know that it's bound to happen in each and every person's life. But keep the faith. Wake up every morning believing. And when you begin to believe, this is something I've personally experienced, and I'd like to spread this, that when you begin to believe, the signs are everywhere.
Correct.
It's ridiculously, it's uncanny how things come at you when you believe you deserve them.
Mm.
Right? It's a beautiful state. So begin to believe, and things, you will just begin to see the signs everywhere. Things will happen for you for sure, but keep the faith. I think in the film industry, everybody who I've spoken to, legends, interviews that I watched, all of it says only one thing, which is persevere. Don't give up, because you are not going to be you're not going to be on top every day.
That's true.
You're going to have those days, and how, learning to fight and come out of it the next day feeling happier, feeling more motivated. Do things that make you happy. Like, surround yourself with good people. I think that's very important, right? Because you need people who will encourage you and at the same time tell you harsh realities.
Correct.
Like, I'd love my friends to say, man, I wish you the best for this film.
Yeah.
But then after the film, let's say they didn't like a particular scene, I'd like them to tell me that.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I think what I'm trying to get at with that is that we should encourage conversation. We should and don't compete. Don't try to, like,
don't
compare, because you don't even know what the other person's circumstances and situations are. Not everybody knows everybody's backstory.
Correct.
Right?
So, and everybody does have a story.
Of course. Everybody who I've said this very often,
yeah,
and I will say it again. Every person who's reached the top, you can't criticize them.
Yeah.
They have reached there for a reason.
Correct.
They've done something different from the other person to be able to be at that position.
Yeah.
So us sitting on the outside, I've begun to understand how tough it is. So I will never be able to criticize a person in my own craft, or maybe even achievers in any other, like in sport. Like, I have a lot of good friends who are champion sportsmen. It's remarkable. It's unbelievable.
And so, anything to watch the reviews of Vaanam Kottattum?
Well, go watch the film in theaters, guys. It's an emotional family film with a lot of emotions, with a connect for everyone. And I think you guys will like Sid's music primarily, because Sid Sriram is a genius musician. So watch the film in theaters. Take everyone, take your friends, take your family. You'll enjoy it.
Thank you, Amitash. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you, Karun. Thank you so much.
Amitash is somebody I really love a lot, especially his family. And I want you guys to spread the message of the fact that there are so many youngsters like him who are an inspiration, who has the motivation factor of being who they are for themselves and being talented at the same time. So all the very best.
Thank you, Karun.
All the best.
Thank you so much.
After Hours with Karun Raman and Amitash Pradhan.
After Hours with Karun Raman.